tonight's cover story, Snapshots of Space. The James Webb Telescope has produced the most spectacular images of the universe ever seen.
And a Northwestern University astrophysicist is one of the lucky few researchers who've used the telescope to see back in time. WGN's Mike Lowe reports.
Even astronomers, like when we look at this, we're seeing, we had the same reaction as everyone else.
The images were as astounding as they were artistic.
So this is where stars are being born. This is a star dying.
Space appeared to be a canvas, painted with light, as if by a planetary Pollock.
We're really trying to understand how to connect these images with one another.
But these incredible images were produced by NASA's $10 billion telescope, the James Webb.
And liftoff.
Decollage, liftoff from a tropical rainforest to the edge of time itself. James Webb begins a voyage back to the birth of the universe.
It's like an adventure.
Allison Strom was watching in wonder along with the rest of us.
Webb separation.
Separation Webb Space Telescope. Go Webb!
Now taking its first steps in pursuit of cosmological discovery.
Viewing the clearest and deepest pictures of the universe anyone has ever seen.
There's a sense of romance, I think, about when the images come in, that you are seeing something that no one else has seen before.
She's a Northwestern University astrophysicist.
It's a research center here at Northwestern University.
And was one of the first scientists to have a chance to use the telescope for research.
It means that we're really among a privileged few that get to look at these data for our own science and begin to answer questions that we've wanted to answer for, in my case, I've been trying to do this for a decade.
Strom leads the Cecilia Survey, named after Cecilia Payne, the groundbreaking female astronomer who discovered the substances that make up stars. Now scientists are discovering entirely new galaxies.
Will you be able to see how or where the universe ends, like if there's an end point?
That's a really good question. So we've already seen essentially the furthest back that we can. It's something that we call the cosmic microwave background. It essentially looks like kind of a speckled pattern. So what you're seeing is essentially back when the universe was just a bunch of glowing gas. And so what we're trying to understand is how we get from that sort of soup of gas to this incredibly complex and rich universe that we have today. That's what I am really excited about.
The telescope is orbiting around the sun 1 million miles from Earth.
It's specifically designed to look at some of the most distant objects in creation.
Light travels at a fixed speed. Light from the moon reaches the Earth in about 1 second. Light from the sun reaches the Earth in about 8 minutes. Light from the closest star outside of the Milky Way would take about 4 years to reach the Earth. The James Webb Telescope's infrared capabilities can detect light that's been traveling for 13 billion years, almost back to the Big Bang.
Imagine when you go out and you look at the night sky, everything you're seeing is in the Milky Way.
Inside Northwestern's Center for Interdisciplinary Exploration and Research in Astrophysics.
But it's also kind of fun to think that, you know, we're specks on a cosmic scale, and yet we've learned a lot about how the universe works. We could never have taken these kinds of images before James Webb.
She explained how the Webb telescope and its large mirrors are giving us all a glimpse into the distant past.
The finite speed of light lets us use telescopes as time machines.
So she can study the chemistry of distant galaxies by detecting light that has traveled billions of miles across the universe. The way she does it is by examining the colors in the photos, specifically the amount of light coming from each color. She can determine the density and the temperature, and then calculate the amount of oxygen, hydrogen, and sulfur present.
And all of this gives us clues, essentially, to how galaxies are growing and changing.
She sees her work as a sort of modern-day Rosetta Stone.
It's not just remembering math and science facts.
The key to cracking the code to at least some of the secrets of the universe.
You know, I think as humans, a lot of what we spend time thinking about is where we came from. And a big part of that origin story is where our Earth came from and our solar system came from and our galaxy came from.
But now, thanks to scientists and to the telescope, we're closer than ever to seeing the big picture of the cosmic story that's written in our stars. In Evanston, Mike Lowe, WGN News.